Now mean deviation. Now in mean deviation, as I already wrote here, what we are doing, we are finding the deviation from the mean. Means all the observation, how much they are deviated from the mean, right? Now here three different formulas are there, that is for ungrouped data or raw data, discrete frequency distribution and continuous frequency distribution. Again, I am telling you definition one time of mean deviation, that is the mean of the absolute deviation of the observations of a data from its mean is called mean deviation. It is denoted by MD, that is capital M and D, that is mean deviation, right? The formula for finding mean deviation for ungrouped data is sigma x minus x bar upon n. X, that is your observation, x bar is your mean, and n is your number of observation. And this x minus x bar means absolute difference between observation and mean. Absolute difference means negative sign we ignore over here, right? And n is your total number of observations. For grouped data, your formula is, that is for discrete frequency distribution, mean deviation from formula is sigma f x minus x bar upon n. This already we are finding only, and this absolute value we have to multiply it by our frequency, where x bar is mean, x is your observation, f is the frequency of that particular observation, and n, that is the sum of frequencies. For continuous frequency distribution, mean deviation, same way again, sigma f x minus x bar upon n. Now, as we all know that in continuous frequency distribution, classes are given. So our first step here is to find mid value, that we will consider as our x. And then the same thing will be there. X bar is mean, x here is mid value of that particular class. F is frequency of class, and n is sigma f, that is sum of frequencies, right? Coefficient of mean deviation. Now, what do you mean by coefficient of mean deviation? That is the value which we get by dividing the mean deviation by mean. That is called the coefficient of mean deviation. That is our formula, mean deviation divided by x bar, that is mean. Now this mean deviation, how it is useful in our life? So this mean deviation, it is mostly used in the problems occurring in the social science. And apart from it, it is also useful in our economics, which we study, right? To determine the economic inequality and in computing the distribution of personal wealth in the community or a country, as well as in forecasting the weather and business cycles, right? Now we'll start with the exercise. Now this is your exercise 4.3, first question. The measurements of height in centimeters of 10 soldiers are given below. Find the mean deviation of the height of the soldiers. Now here they've given you the height in centimeters of 10 soldiers. You have to find mean deviation. From word itself you can understand mean deviation, that is the deviation from the mean. As it is raw data, so directly we'll find out the deviation. Now this is my first question. Height in centimeter is given. I'll find out sigma x, that is total of all the observations. I'll get 1674, that is 1674. Now I'll find out x bar, that is sigma x, 1674. And how many number of observations are given to us? That is 10. So 1674 divided by 10 is equal to 167.4. So this is my x bar or mean, we can say, right? Now x minus x bar we'll find. Now here I have written this x minus x bar in bracket. So absolute value I have to find. Then a one column more I have to make to find the absolute value, that is to ignore the negative sign. Or directly we can make this column only as our absolute deviation. So this type of thing will be used, right? Anything you can do, first you can find x minus x bar and then you can find the absolute value, or you can directly make the absolute column. Now my x bar is 167.4. So x is 160 minus x bar, that is 167.4. That will give me minus 7.4. Now as here I am directly writing the absolute value, so I'll ignore negative sign, I'll directly write down 7.4. 175 minus 167.4, it will give me answer 7.6. 158 minus 167.4, I'll get 9.4. 165 minus 167.4, I'll get 2.4. 170 minus 167.4, 2.6. 166 minus 167.4, that will give you 1.4. 173 minus 167.4, that will give you 5.6. 176 minus 167.4, that will give you 8.6. 163 minus 167.4, that will give you 4.4. And 168 minus 167.4, that will give you 0.6. Now we have to find the addition of these absolute values, that is x minus x bar total. So we will do total of this 7.4, 7.6 plus 7.9.4 plus 2.4 plus 2.6 plus 1.4 plus 5.6 plus 8.6 plus 4.4 plus 0.6. So I'll get my sigma x minus x bar as 50. Now I'll put it in my mean deviation of height. So my mean deviation formula is sigma, absolute value is there, so x minus x bar upon n. Now this value already I got, that is 50. My n is 10, so therefore my mean deviation is 5 cm. Now second question, the distribution of number of ball bearings used in machines of a factory is given below. Calculate the mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation of number of ball bearing per machine. Here both you have to calculate mean deviation as well as coefficient of mean deviation. Discrete frequency distribution is there, number of ball bearings and number of machines, that is x and f. Now question number 2, here number of ball bearings, that is your x, and number of machines, that is your f, is given to us. Here first of all, we'll find out fx. For finding mean, fx, that is x multiplied by f, or f multiplied by x. So 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 6 4's are 24, 8 5's are 40, 10 3's are 30, 12 2's are 24, 14 1's are 14, and 16 1's are 16. Now we'll find out fx total, that will be our sigma fx. So when total we'll do, we'll get our sigma fx as 160. Now we'll find out mean. Our formula for finding mean is sigma fx upon n. Our sigma fx is 160, n is 20. So 160, when we'll divide it by 20, we'll get our answer as 8 ball bearing. Now we'll find out deviation from the mean. Now our mean is 8, so we'll find out deviation from the mean. First of all, absolute deviation, that means ignore negative sign. So here I am writing my x bar is 8. Now here usually take into consideration this x column. Whenever generally students are doing fast calculation, they take mistake from f, they subtract. Okay, so that much attention you have to pay. So x minus x bar, so that means this first column you have to take into consideration. So 2 minus 8, that is equal to minus 6, and negative sign I am ignoring, so here it will come 6. Now 4 minus 8, that will give you minus 4. I'll write down no negative sign, so 4. 6 minus 8, 2. 8 minus 8, 0. Then 10 minus 8, that is 2. 12 minus 8, 4. 14 minus 8, 6. And 16 minus 8, 8. Right? Now I'll to find f multiply by x minus x bar, that is absolute value of x minus x bar, and f. So that means this column and this one, these two I have to take into consideration. F multiply by this, so 2 multiply by 6, that is 12. 2 multiply by 4, that is 8. 4 multiply by 2, that is 8. 5 multiply by 0, 0. 3 multiply by 2, that is equal to 6. 2 multiply by 4, that is equal to 8. 1 multiply by 6, that is equal to 6. And 1 multiply by 8, that is equal to 8. Now I have to do total of this column, that is sigma f x minus x bar. So that will come to 56. Now I will find out mean deviation. So what is my formula for finding mean deviation? Mean deviation is equal to sigma f x minus x bar upon n. Now here x minus x bar is 56 upon n is 20. So 56, when you will divide it by 20, you will get your answer as 2.8. So that is my mean deviation is equal to 2.8 ball bearing. Now I have to find coefficient of mean deviation of ball bearing. So what is my formula of coefficient of mean deviation? Mean deviation divided by mean. So that is mean deviation divided by x bar. Mean deviation is 2.8 and my mean is 8. So 2.8, when you will divide it by 8, your value will come 0.35. So that is my coefficient of mean deviation. Question number 3. Find the mean deviation and the coefficient of mean deviation of the distribution of talk time in minutes per call. So talk time in minutes and number of calls, discrete, again discrete frequency distribution is given to us. Same way we have to find x minus x bar, that is deviation, and f x minus x bar. Now for mean deviation, discrete frequency distribution, make 5 columns. X and f is given. First of all, we will find out fx. 3 4s are 5 7s are 10 6s are 12 2s are 15 1s are. Total of this fx, that is equal to 146. Now what is my formula for finding mean? That is sigma fx upon n. Sigma fx is 146, n is 20. So 146, when I'll divide it by 20, I'll get my answer as 7.3, as it is given in minutes. Now I have to find mean deviation. So for that I will calculate first of all absolute value, and x bar here it is 7.3, and then I will find out f x minus x bar. X bar I am having now x minus x bar. So 3 minus 7.3, that is 4.3. Absolute value is there, that's why I am not speaking, that negative sign is there. So I am ignoring that sign, I am writing positive value. 5 minus 7.3, that is 2.3, minus 2.3. Negative sign is ignored, so 2.3. 10 minus 7.3, that is 2.7. 12 minus 7.3, that is 4.7. And 15 minus 7.3, that is equal to 7.7. Now I will find out fx minus x bar. This is my f, so that means this column multiply by this column, this 2 I will multiply. 4 multiplied by 4.3, that will give you 17.2. 7 multiplied by 2.3, 16.1. 6 multiplied by 2.7, 16.2, 2 multiplied by 4.7, 9.4, and 1 multiplied by 7.7, 7.7. Now addition of all these values, 17.2 plus 16.1 plus 16.2 plus 9.4 plus 7.7. So that will give you 66.6. Now mean deviation formula, sigma fx minus x bar upon n. I'll put it in my value, 66.6. n is 20 divided by 20. So that will give me 66.6 divided by 20, 3.33. So therefore, my mean deviation is equal to 3.33 minutes. Now coefficient of mean deviation of talk time. So my formula for coefficient of mean deviation is mean deviation divided by x bar. Mean deviation is 3.33 and x bar is 7.3. So 3.33 divided by x bar that is 7.3 is equal to 0.46. Question number 4. Find the mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation of number of TV sets using the following frequency distribution of TV sets sold in last 16 months in a town. That is your total of frequency 16N, and number of TV sets is given and number of months. Now here, as you can see, classes are given, continuous frequency distribution is there. Okay, so here we have to add two more columns. That is, first we have to find mid value, which we will consider it as our x. Now here number of TV sets is given to you, that is class and frequency is given. So first of all, here one more column will get added of x, otherwise all same columns are, that is fx, x minus x bar and fx minus x bar. X will find 10 plus 30 divided by 2, so that will give you 20. 30 plus 50 divided by 2, that will give you 40. 50 plus 70 divided by 2, that will give you 60. 70 plus 90 divided by 2, 80. And 90 plus 110 divided by 2, 100. Now we'll find out fx, f multiplied by x. So 1 multiplied by 20, that is equal to 20. 4 multiplied by 40, 160. 6 multiplied by 60, 360. 4 multiplied by 80, 320, and 1 multiplied by 100, that is 100. Now do the total of fx column. We'll get our answer as sigma fx, that is equal to 960. Now we can find out mean. What is our formula? Sigma fx upon n. Sigma fx value is 960 divided by 16. So 960 divided by 16 is equal to 60 TV sets. Now mean deviation of monthly sales of TV sets, sigma fx minus x bar. So first of all, we'll find out deviation. X bar is 60 and x, that means this column we have to consider, x minus x bar. 20 minus 60, 40, negative sign we are ignoring, absolute value we are finding, absolute deviation. 40 minus 60, 20, 60 minus 60, 0, 80 minus 60, 20, 100 minus 60, 40. Now f x minus x bar, f means f and x minus x bar, these two column multiply. 1 multiplied by 40 is 40, 4 multiplied by 20 is 80, 6 multiplied by 0 is 0, 4 multiplied by 20 is 80, and 1 multiplied by 40 is 40. Do the addition. So we'll get as 240. Now we'll put it in our formula, that is mean deviation, sigma fx minus x bar upon n. That is equal to 240 divided by n is 16. Now when you'll divide 240 by 16, you'll get your answer as 15. So I can say that my mean deviation is equal to 15 TV sets. Now coefficient of mean deviation. Mean deviation is 15. My x bar is 60. So 15 when I'll divide it by 60, my mean deviation is 0.6. 5. Question number 5. There are 50 boxes containing different number of units of an item in a factory. Find the mean deviation of number of units per box using the following distribution of the units. Again, continuous frequency distribution. First we'll find mid value and then we'll calculate. 50 boxes, that is your n. Now number of units and number of boxes, that is frequency, is given to me. First I will find out x from class, and then same three things. Mid value x, 0 plus 10 divided by 2, 5, 10 plus 20 divided by 2, 15. Now here, as you can see, class length is same, 10. So here my mid value 5, 15, 25. Here it will come 35, 45, 55 and 65. Now fx I have to find, f multiplied by x. 6 multiplied by 5, 30. 5 multiplied by 15, 75. 8 multiplied by 25, 200. 15 multiplied by 35, 525. 7 multiplied by 45, 315. 6 multiplied by 55, 330. And 3 multiplied by 65, 195. Total of your fx column, it will come to 1670. Now I'll find out mean. My sigma fx here is 1670 divided by n. Divided, we'll get our answer as 33.4 units. Now I have to find mean deviation of number of units. For that I'll do calculation. Here my x bar is 33.4. Now same way we have to find this column, x minus x bar column. 5 minus 33.4, 28.4, 15 minus 33.4, 18.4, 25 minus 33.4, 8.4, 35 minus 33.4, 1.6, 45 minus 33.4, 11.6, 55 minus 33.4, 21.6, and 65 minus 33.4, that is equal to 31.6. Now we have to multiply it with F column, that is this one. So F multiplied by X minus X bar. 6 multiplied by 28.4, 170.4. 5 multiplied by 18.4, 92. 8 multiplied by 8.4, 67. 15 multiplied by 1.6, 24. 7 multiplied by 11.6, that is equal to 81.2. 6 multiplied by 21.6, that is equal to 129.6. And 3 multiplied by 31.6, that is equal to 94.8. Now the total of this column, that is 659.2. Now we'll replace it in our formula. So sigma fx minus x bar, that is equal to 659.2 divided by n is 50. So when we'll divide, we'll get our mean deviation as 13.18 units. That is, mean deviation is equal to 13.18 units.